How a module can be lazily loaded in Angular, we will see that, but after the intro. Hey everyone, this is Subrat and you are watching Fun of Heuristics. On this channel, you will get to know about the programming languages, the framework and all about the algorithm. So please consider subscribing and hit that bell icon if you haven't yet. So before jumping into the video, we should know what is lazy loading and what is the benefit of it. So lazy loading basically means, as its name says, is lazy to be loaded. That means a function or a method or a module is lazily loaded means you need to call that function so that it will execute or load itself, or the data need to be loaded to it. So we'll go to the application. So you can see here, I have just created a normal CLI application. So all this file you are seeing here is the CLI created file. So we have one routing files, one modules files, and this normal component. So you need a routing component so that on call of that route you will load the module. So that's how we'll achieve the lazy loading of a module. So I will go to the code. I will write ng, g for generate, m for module, and I will just try home. So it will, a home module will be, should be get created here. We'll see. Okay, home is just added. Now you will see that inside that we have home.module.ts, which is similar as our app module. So as the module is created, we will add a component to it. Okay, so to add a component, I will just go inside that module. Okay, so just click here and I will just write ng generate component, and I just write picture. I don't know why, but I just wrote picture. I'm not going to create a picture on it. So you can see the picture is just created. And that picture you have to add here. What you can do, you can pass while creating a module tag and pass the module, and that will be get added to the picture. And now as you added the picture component in the declaration, so now we'll go to the app routing module. You have to give the load children, and in that load children you have to pass the module itself. So for this file, the home is on the same directory, so we'll go to /home, just home.module.ts, and we don't need the ts part from here. Then we can give a hashtag and the module name. Module name means this one, just home module. Just go and copy paste it here. So now it's become lazy loaded because, okay, to show you, I need to add a module also, component here also. So ng generate component, I will suppose add login just for the sake of adding a component. So it will be get added here, not in the home. I should give this as a home module, not, or I should put it, if you are putting it, just put it inside a modules folder so it will be distinguished. Now it seems like home and login is same. So, but you got the point. And one more thing, I forgot to tell you that we need a routing inside the home component itself, so that router module need to be passed to the app router module. Okay, so here we'll create a file. And one more thing is, as you can see here, we have for root, that is for the root. And here, as the name says, we need for child. And after you add the for child, what you have to do, like, just need to import it to your module. Okay, so in a home module, the routing is added. So the basic concept will be like, you have a routing model which has home module as lazily loaded, and inside that home module you have another routing module which shows or which give your parent routing module a path, like suppose a parent routing module asks slash home, which is this. So that will just load this module, and in that module we have, if to this module, if path is empty string, load the picture component. So I will start the application again. Okay, now we will go to the browser and see as just a normal application. So a login works is here in the corner. Okay, so now we'll go to home. Okay, so here I'll just write home, and you can see the only change is here, picture work. Okay, what I will do, I will just change a bit. So now we're gonna check, is it really lazily loaded to the application or not. Okay, so we'll go to the application. When you click on the home, you'll see that we got home.module.ts is added to the application. But when I'm pressing the login option, just check, nothing is get added. And now as home is already loaded to the application, it will not reload it again by the browser because it's already cached. So you can say, okay, login was already loaded, so that may be also a case. Okay, so I will go to the application and I'll just try to add profile here, and I will go to the routing module, and here we'll add a path. So what I'm showing you now, I'm hitting the home component. So you saw that the home component get loaded, and when I'm going back again to the login component, nothing is like get loaded. Now the time is when I hit the profile here, also you can see nothing is loaded. That means the whole module is lazily loaded to the application. So that's it for today, guys. So today we saw how we can load a module lazily in Angular so that the experience can be better. And if you like the video and if you want to support me, you can support me on the Patreon. I will give the link in the description below. You can go and check that once. And like the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Don't forget to hit that bell icon. Share this video among your friends, family, whoever want to learn the code. We're going to meet in the next video. Till that, stay happy. Bye-bye.